Hi, this is Kevin Conroy, and you're listening to the GeekCast Radio Network.
This is Matt Vervoise from LALA Land Records, and you've entered the LALA Land Lounge on GeekCast Radio.
Hello and welcome to the LALA Land Lounge here on GeekCast Radio. I am, of course, TF2 and Mike, and this is episode 10 of the LALA Land Lounge, and it's been a while since we've done one of these, but joining me is Steve Megatron. Hello.
Hello.
And as of this recording, September 5th, 1992, I'm sorry, 2017, it has been 25 years to the day since Batman the Animated Series came out.
Since Cat in the Claw.
No, on leather wings.
I know. They were saying, though, that wasn't... They were saying that it was 25 years from the that episode. Specifically.
Well, yeah, because wasn't that the first one that got shown?
Yeah.
Even though On Leather Wings is the actual first episode.
Yes.
The air order back then was stupid.
Yes.
Yes, so we are here to talk about Volume 3 and Volume 4 of La La Land Records, Batman the Animated Series soundtracks. For Volume 3, we have music by Shirley Walker, Carlos Rodriguez, Peter Tomaszek, Todd Hayden, Harvey R. Cohen, Michael McQuestion, Lars Cutterham, Stuart Balcom, Mark Koval, Lolita Romanos, Richard Brunskill, Tamara Klein, Carl Johnson, Steve Chesney, and James Stemple. La La Land Records, Warner Brothers Animation, and DC Comics proudly present Batman the Animated Series Volume 3, a limited edition 4-CD set of unforgettable musical moments from the acclaimed Batman the Animated Series. These remarkable scores are game changers in the world of television animation music, packing a supercharged thrills, chills, action, and drama within an emotional musical whirlwind that rivals most blockbuster film scores. Music from such notable episodes as Robin's Reckoning, Eternal Youth, Day of the Samurai, Mudslide, The Clock King, and more are presented here in a knockout compilation with a combined running time of more than 5 hours. Produced by John Takas and Neil S. Bulk, and mastered by James Nelson, this limited edition of 3,000 units features 36-page booklet bursting with amazing images and in-depth liner notes and analysis by John Takas. The heroic art design by Dan Goldwasser complements this impressive volume with the gothic flair. As of this recording, folks, it's probably going to change, but as of this recording, this set is on sale for $40 at LALALandRecords.com. So head on over there. The regular price is $60. But yeah, Volume 3 has so many good scores on it.
Yep.
Yep. What was your favorite from... Okay, so let me just run this down really quick. I'm gonna run this down disc by disc. What was your... Let's see. Disc 1, we've got Robin's Reckoning. POV, The Clock King, Tiger Tiger, See No Evil. So what is your favorite of those from disc 1?
kind of like Robin's Reckoning, but at the same time, I like The Clock King.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's The Clock King. It's all about time.
Yes. Time is up. Yes.
Your time is running up, Batman.
Yep. Absolutely. For me, I love Robin's Reckoning. Both part one and part two. Part one was done by Carlos Rodriguez, and part two was done by Peter Tomaszek. Love that one. I love POV, which was done by Shirley Walker. Because POV was that really cool episode. At least for me, it was a cool episode where you get to see three different points of view of the episode. You get to see Bullock's, Wilkes's, and Montoya's POV, which is really, really awesome. I do like The Clock King as well. I like See No Evil. See No Evil was the little girl. That's right. With her dad being the... Yeah, I remember that episode now. But yeah, no, the instrumentals done in POV and in Robin's Reckoning. I mean, Robin's Reckoning, it's essentially the story of the Graysons and their death and all of that.
Well, there's a varying degree of... not only do you have two different composers for part one and part two, but you have two different styles, as it were, as you get the evolution of Dick Grayson.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. On disc two for this, we have Cat Scratch Fever, done by Harvey R. Cohen. The Forgotten, done by Shirley Walker. Be a Clown, which is Michael McQuistion's. Let's see. Dreams in Darkness, which is Todd Hayden. The Underdwellers, which is Lars Clutterham and Stuart Balcom, both. And then Terror in the Sky, which is done by Shirley Walker. I've been waiting. Of course, this got released a couple of years ago, this set. But technically, I've been waiting 25 years for the music from the episode The Forgotten. Because that's the episode where Bruce, you know, becomes homeless and kinda, sorta, loses his memory kind of thing and ends up on this chain gang and everything else. And Alfred has to come in the Batwing and save him. And I love that Western music that's in this.
Oh yeah, it's got that weird... There was this instance in the 90s where every show that came out had to have an episode that was very Westerns oriented, especially with the soundtrack and the visuals. And when I watched, it kind of reminds me of that Coming of the Fusors Part 2 and Part 1.
Yep.
Well, Part 1 and Part 2. But yeah, it's a lot of the kind of same musical aspects of that Western stuff popping in just kind of reminds that.
Yeah, absolutely.
I don't know, it ties multiple shows together in my childhood just by watching that.
Oh yeah, absolutely. And I love all of these tracks here. The Oven is probably my favorite one. It's only 47 seconds, but it's that...
Put him in the hot box.
Yeah, put him in the hot box. And yeah. Bruce's family flashback is nice. Sweatbox Breakout / Trapped in the Canyon, that's good. Mining for Batman, I believe, is the track right when it's Alfred coming in to save him in the Batwing, so that's cool.
Yep.
The other one on disc two that I liked was I'm trying to think here. Yeah, I like The Forgotten pretty much. I did like Dreams in Darkness, because that's the one where, you know, he's cracking up, and it's a lot of psychological stuff in that episode for Batman with Dreams in Darkness, and that one was done by Todd Hayden. Or Todd Hayden, I should say.
I kind of like the... anytime there's a Be a Clown.
Yeah.
Just because there's a lot of memorable music and kind of that creepy yet jolly sound to it.
Mm-hmm.
But you get Jekko the Clown.
With Mayor Hill and his son.
Yep, I remember that one, yeah.
Jekko's my friend. No, he's trying to kill you.
Yes, he is. Yeah.
Be and the roller coaster of doom.
Mm-hmm. Yep, the roller coaster of doom. You killed Captain... It's the wrong episode, but you killed Captain Clown. Yeah.
You killed Captain Clown.
Disc 3 offers something that most people would not have heard on television. The first track on Disc 3 is the opening title sequence, but it's the demo version where it's basically dueling piano. It's not really dueling, but it's two pianos, and it's Shirley Walker and Danny Elfman together on the pianos. That is cool. I like that. Other ones on this that are here, we've got Night of the Ninja, Day of the Samurai, so that's kind of like the two-parter there. Prophecy of Doom, Eternal Youth, What is Reality, Mudslide, and those are the ones on this one. Eternal Youth is probably my favorite off of this disc, because it wasn't very often that Alfred got many stories. I mean, Alfred's there as he's supposed to be, but Eternal Youth is pretty much him and his lady love Maggie.
Well, and he's trying to regain youth, as it were.
Yeah, yeah.
And Bruce is like, oh no. And has to go, like, save him the whole episode. It's just a big oh no episode.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Absolutely love that one. Which one off of this did you like?
What is Reality?
Mm-hmm.
That's, I love that whole episode. I especially like when they're in the computer land. Mm-hmm. And, that was one of the first episodes of the show that I originally saw when I was a kid, and it may be the first I remember that I really enjoyed, but that's the one that cemented the Riddler for me. And between the visuals and the sound cues that go with it, that episode just has always stood out for me.
Yeah.
So I really loved the work on that particular episode. And then there's the... I like a lot of the Night of the Ninja and the Day of the Samurai, but that's because I like hearing the kind of influence of a different kind of aspect of a different type of people.
Right.
Influenced into it, and the samurai and everything in there. It's just, I don't know. It's something different that we get in there. I mean, every track and every episode's different, but you get that kind of a little bit of behind the scenes of Bruce's younger years, but you also get the kind of something that's not necessarily Batman-centric music.
Yeah, Night of the Ninja, Day of the Samurai, technically, kinda, sorta, really is a two-parter. And it's basically two sides of the same coin, where I think Night of the Ninja is more to show off Kyodai's senses and things like that, and then Day of the Samurai is kind of showing off Bruce's stuff, you know, like you said, when he's younger and all of that. And I like it. It's very unique, it's very different, and it's not, like you said, it's not traditional Batman themes, because the episode focuses more on Bruce than it does Batman. That's, again, why I like The Forgotten so much, is outside of the fact that it's Western music, it's also dealing, like, Bruce can't remember who the hell he is, so he can't become Batman. You're not gonna get, you know, until, like, the very end of the episode, you don't get a traditional Batman, you know, hero theme. You get the Western type stuff.
Mm-hmm.
The fourth disc includes I Am the Night, done by Michael McQuestion. Heart of Steel, Parts 1 and 2. Part 1 was done by Richard Bronskill and Tamara Klein. Part 2 was done by Carl Johnson. Blind as a Bat, done by Steve Chesney and James Stemple. Paging the Crime Doctor, done by Shirley Walker. The Man Who Killed Batman, done by Shirley Walker. And then we get the end credits sequence there. For me, off disc 4, it's easily Heart of Steel.
Mm-hmm.
It's easily
gonna say that too.
Heart of Steel. I mean, I like all of this music, folks. I'm not just saying, oh, I only like this, but it's basically like Heart of Steel is number one for me, and then Blind as a Bat would be a close second off of this fourth disc here. And then I assume it's been, you know, preserved and things, but what I've noticed is some of the La La Land record stuff, when they do the closing themes, wait until the end of that 45 seconds. You can actually hear Shirley Walker wrapping up the orchestra and the music. It's just so good, folks. It's like, you know, being a fly on the wall in one of those recording sessions. And it's just so fun. It really is, because none of us are going to... I mean, it's been 11 years since Shirley died. And, you know, just be... Like, she's on this one, I believe. I know she's on the Superman set one, at one of the closing theme things as well. And I first heard it there, more so here at the time, and I'm like, oh, wow. We get a behind-the-scenes listen into what it was like to be doing this music oh so long ago. Yeah, just absolutely awesome. But yeah, I mean, Heart of Steel, how do you not like that episode? That's, you know, that's the hard act and all of that, and, you know... You know, the briefcase on the prowl. Good. Damn briefcase. I don't think I ever want to see a briefcase ever again after watching that episode.
Nope. Creepy case.
Uh-huh. Creepy robotic thing.
Hardak was one of the ones that I like from, you know, the Heart of Steel stuff. Mm-hmm. The other one that I like is The Man Who Killed Batman.
Okay.
Again, it's a Joker episode, so...
That's right, I forgot about that.
But I actually... the funny thing was, is I was trying, when I was taking acting classes in college, because you had to take it for anything media-related,
mm-hmm.
You had to choose your own monologue, but it mm-hmm. had to be from a television show.
Right.
I chose mine from this episode.
Oh, wow. What was the monologue?
The one Batman's funeral,
okay.
where Sid meets the Joker, and the Joker does the, you know, "Dear friends, today's the day the clown cried." And he cried not for, you know, and then, so I went through the whole thing, and then, up to the point where he goes, "Take that man there, slap him in that box there,
yeah.
and roll it into that vat of acid there." And then he's like, "Who wants Chinese?" After, you know, he throws him in the thing, and then Batman reemerges at the end of the episode to save the guys in the coffin, and he kind of floats out of the river alive, and... Batman's all getting his costume eaten away because he's saving this loser.
Yep.
So it was a fun episode, but just watching this Sid guy who accidentally killed Batman, and everybody's like, "He killed the bat," and then Joker's like, this is just bad comedy. Like,
mm-hmm.
he's like, this can't happen.
Absolutely, yeah. The Man Who Killed Batman, the music in that was really, really well done. Absolutely love that one as well. If you haven't, folks...
And the kazoo of the Amazing Grace of for Batman's funeral is the,
yeah.
the coffin's getting lowered into the water.
Yes, I remember the kazoo. That's awesome. There needs to be more kazoo in Batman. Yeah, and if you haven't gotten this, folks, go on over to La La Land Records right now as you're listening to this, pick up Batman the Animated Series Volume 3 and enjoy all of this amazing 90s animation music stuff. We're going to take a quick break, and we're going to come back with Volume 4 after this. Alright folks, we are back here inside the La La Land Lounge. Hope you enjoyed that musical interlude of Batman the Animated Series Volume 3 and teasing up a little bit for Volume 4 here, because Volume 4, La La Land Records, DC, and Warner Brothers Animation present the fourth and final volume in the acclaimed series of Batman the Animated Series original score releases. Now, before I go any further reading this copy, this volume completes all 65 original episodes. Will they go and do Adventures of Batman and Robin, the new adventures, and all of that? Yes, they probably will. But this, when I say that this, you know, completes these releases of the original scores, this is just the original first season of the cartoon series, because they didn't know if they were going to get picked up. Obviously, they did. They changed the show a little bit as they went along, obviously, but this, you know, marks that. Batman Anime Series Volume 4, limited edition 2-CD set. Once again, the listener is musically transported into the heart of Gotham by some of the most notable scored music ever composed for an animated television series. BTAS continues to be revered as one of the finest examples in the genre, and the show's music is vital, an undeniable part of its legacy. Treasured episode scores such as Joker's Wild, Moon of the Wolf, His Silicon Soul, and more make their debut here, complemented by a healthy serving of more previously unreleased music from the Arkham Archives. Produced by John Takas and Neil S. Bulk, and mastered by James Nelson, this special limited edition 2-CD set features exclusive in-depth liner notes by album co-producer Takas, an art design worthy of a Cape Crusader by Jim Titus, limited edition of 3,000 units. As I said earlier in this podcast, as of this recording, this is on sale on lalalandrecords.com for $20. So, yeah, folks, go grab you some BTAS music. We're going to go through this like we went through the other volume here. On disc one, we have Off Balance, Joker's Wild, Cape and Cowl's Conspiracy, and then we've got Zatanna, Moon of the Wolf, and The Mechanic. So pick your poison, Joker.
So I like Joker's Wild, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
But it's funny because this one's the one where Kaiser builds a Joker-themed casino. Yep. Intentionally hoping the Joker would blow it up so he can collect the cash for the insurance, and Batman points it out to the Joker in this one, and he's like, "I hate it when he's right. I'll sell this man to clown." I love the where the Joker escapes, and the various Joker music in the themes of the casino itself.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of my favorites. I like The Mechanic as well.
Yeah, that was because about Batman's mechanic.
Yeah, and you get the Batmobile blown to pieces, and
a poor Batmobile. Damn it.
Hey, yeah. at least Bruce Timm brought it back for the Batman and Harley.
Very true.
And he brought it back again for the Killing Joke. So that goes to show you that's his favorite Batmobile.
Yep.
Mine too, so I love it. And Zatanna's kind of cool too, though, because you get the magic element.
Yes.
Added in. So it kind of, just like the Western theme and the samurai theme, you get the magic theme. And so it just adds something extra.
Yeah, it really does. Zatanna was such a good score. That one is Peter Tomaszek and Nerida Tyson Chu. I love the Zatanna one. Absolutely. I love the mechanic one because, like we said, the Batmobile. But for me, number one off of this disc, it has to be the Cape and Cowl Conspiracy. Because that episode had such twists and turns. And just when you thought it was solved, it wasn't. Batman turned it on its head. And, like, I was not expecting him to be behind the chair at the end of that one. Like, at all. Was not expecting him to be in the mask of the dude, the criminal dude. Yep. Absolutely love that one. Alright, let's see here. Disc two, I should say. The Warrior Men, Fear of Victory, and His Silicon Soul. After that, we have the Arkham Archives, special bonus section of previously unreleased music, which includes the Police Response from On Leather Wings. We have Christmas with the Joker, God Rest You Merry Gentlemen, traditional arranged by Michael McQuestion. Pukey Jingle Bells, Sweetener, James Pierpoint, arranged by Shirley Walker. To the Observatory, Lolita Romanus, a word from our sponsor, Shirley Walker. Auld Lang Syne, traditional arranged by Michael McQuestion. We've got The Last Laugh, Bruce Shaves, which is done by Shirley Walker, and the epilogue, also done by Shirley. Pretty Poison, The Underdwellers, Be a Clown, The Circus Source 2, which was unused in the episode. And then we got a couple of things from Two-Face Parts 1 and 2, It's Never Too Late, Joker's Favor, Vendetta, The Clock King, Perchance to Dream, Robin's Reckoning, If You're So Smart, Why Aren't You Rich, and Almost Got Him, which includes a Club Source number 4, Alternate by Stuart Balcombe, and then Drumstick.
Hit him with a rock.
Yeah, hit him with a rock. It was a big rock. But we also have the drum sting here. It's basically a rim shot, folks. It's basically one of those, you know, drum rim shots. And I'm like, oh my god, I have to use that more. I'll be using that more probably and stuff. And then the final ones are from Birds of a Feather. And then the end credits theme for Batman the Animated Series. Disc 2, outside of the bonus material, I would probably have to say His Silicon Soul, most likely. It was done by Carl Johnson and Harvey R. Cohen.
Yeah, I really love that episode in general, but the elements of it where you kind of get a lot of the back and forth and kind of the robo hard act moments, and then you get a lot of the troubling, you know, of the machinery with the fact that it's a confused, conflicted human copy of Bruce Wayne.
Yeah.
And the fact that he, you know, just the whole episode's great, but like, the music is, it adds to the personality of the hard act Batman and kind of detracts from regular Batman and kind of makes you care about that character.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, so these tracks, this is disc 2, tracks 14 to 19. His Silicon Soul, The Wayne Manor, Robo gas, on with my life. Robo gets zapped, greenhouse shattered, a learning program, warehouse fight, and then Hardak is reborn over the edge. Robo soul. The music for this to give not only personality, but a sense of, oh my god, which Batman is which. Like, if obviously we didn't see that the Robo Batman was all terminated up and all that, like, really, if we didn't know that already as the audience, like, it would be hard to tell which one was which, I think. I mean, obviously they gave him the red eyes, so we as the audience could tell the difference, but with the music and just how tortured the robot's soul becomes, it's just so damn good. And the music complements that 10 times over.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Absolutely. What did you think of the special bonus section of the previously unreleased stuff?
A lot of Joker material, which was spectacular for me.
Mm-hmm.
Because you get a lot of extras from Christmas with the Joker, Last Laugh, Be a Clown. Two-Face stuff's always great, just because you get... They're always playing the double-edged sword with his character, just because you have two personalities going at a time. Then you have Joker's favor, and then I don't know, there's a lot of the episodes that, I mean, if you're so smart, why aren't you rich? The Clock King, Almost Got Him. A lot of the episode bonus material for the Arkham archives,
mm-hmm,
is a part of episodes I already enjoy, so like just adding that extra material, I can picture elements of the episodes from the stuff used, so it's kind of interesting to hear some of the things that were used in it.
Right. So basically, folks, for $80, you can get all four volumes of Batman the Animated Series. Under $100, you can get all of these sets right now, as of this recording on LALA LAND Records. That's amazing that they're doing that.
Oh, yeah.
It's a flash sale. September 5th marks 25th anniversary of the television premiere. Well, you better hurry up, folks, because it expires on September 6th. So, under $80, you can get all four of them. I should say under $100, you can get all four of them, but act fast. The BTAS music, absolutely love that. My buddy Ender, everybody should know Ender. Ender is amazing. He asked me when I reshared the art image for this, he's like, what, no Batman Beyond? And I basically said, well, the last time that was released was almost 20 years ago, so until La La Land, which, you know, I'm pretty sure they're going to eventually get to Batman Beyond, which would be cool as hell. We'll get to that eventually. I do plan on doing more La La Land Lounge releases, folks. It's been a little hectic around here, but I do plan on getting back to it. Volume 3, I'd probably give a 4 out of 5. What about you for Volume 3?
Volume 3, I'll give it a 4 out of 5.
Mm-hmm. Volume 4, I will give a 3.5 out of 5. What about you?
I'll give it about a 4, just because there's more of the bonus material. I love anytime Riddler and Joker episodes come up, so...
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Join us next time here on GeekCast Radio inside the La La Land Lounge for, I mean, who knows? I might end up doing, you know, Transformers The Last Night or Age of Extinction or I don't know, whatever I haven't already reviewed.
The Last Night?
Leave the music alone. Leave the music is good. That's the only thing that's good about those Transformers movies.
I'd have to listen to the music on its own without the film to get more out of it.
Well,
because otherwise I hear garbage trucks smashing into each other. So,
yes. Well, we'll talk about that later. Everybody, please head on over to LALALandRecords.com where soundtracks live. We will catch you next time here on GeekCast Radio.
Myself. I think just this morning I stood in this very place and said,